please put your hands together for Bronston Jones, everyone.
How are we doing? Good? Apparently she hates me already. I haven't said shit. All right, we'll see you in a little bit. Oh, but she replaced it. What? We're good? I'm going to put this right here. Don't Cosby it, all right? If you were offended by that joke, you're either a fan of Cosby or you've been asleep for the last couple years. Which means you might be a friend of Cosby. All right, you guys are creepy. That was a good joke right out of the gate. I like these first class passengers right here. These are the best seats in the house. And I love how comfortable you look with your food. You're just like, everybody fucking watch me eat. It's a commercial for Sliders. That's what that is. Oh, man. So it's Friday. Is it Friday? Saturday, right?
Saturday.
That's the life of a comic. I'm like, I don't know what day of the week it is. Saturday night. So are we getting loaded for 4th of July? Is that what's happening?
Yeah.
We're celebrating America by going, thank you, forefathers. Love it. I heard my favorite sound when I just asked if we were getting loaded. Favorite sound in the whole world came from right around that region. It was a woo! Only ladies make the woo sound, right, guys? Oh, this one is cool. Ladies, I love that sound. That sound is the great sound. You know what that is? That is the sound of a woman on the town getting ready to have some fun, letting go of your life's problems. You look like you let go of your life's problems a long time ago. You don't give a shit. Like, whatever my problem is, just drown it. It's fine. Holy fuck. I love that sound. This is what it is. Have you guys ever gone out, like, this is for the guys and the girls, right? Is you go out on a Tinder date, you meet somebody new. And by the way, Tinder and Bumble, is anybody on those apps? That's not really how it works, but I appreciate. For those of you in a solid relationship, for those of you who are married, you should know this because 50% of you will be divorced in the future. Tinder's a dating app where really all you do is you just look at somebody's picture and you swipe it right to say, oh, that person's cute, or you swipe left, I don't like this person, right? And ladies, I don't know if you know this, but you know when men do most of their Tindering, when they're judging you the most, is when they're sitting on the shitter. So just think about that the next time you accept somebody, you're like, oh, this guy really liked me, wants to take a dump. So I meet my Tinder date, and this is how it always goes. You meet somebody, and you're like, hey, it's good to meet you. You know, this bar's really nice. Would you like a drink? No pressure at all. No pressure to drink at all. But I'm definitely going to have a drink. Would you like one? Girls are always like this. Wow. I have a lot of stuff I need to do tomorrow. But okay, I will have one. I will have one drink. And I'm like, what would you like? She goes, vodka soda. That sounds good. And I go, vodka soda? That sounds boring. This is going to be a horrible date. So I will have a shot to go with my beer, right? I will finish that. She will take her drink. She'll be like, hello, I have to work tomorrow. I don't know, whatever you girls talk about on a first date, I don't listen. So she finishes that first drink. I'm like, you're done with that. That's cool. I'm definitely going to have another drink because I'm a giant. It takes a lot of fuel to fill this truck. Would you like another drink? No pressure. She'd be like, well, I gotta go to the gym first thing. So it should be something healthy. Okay, an Appletini. I'll take an Appletini. All right, moving up in the world. One Appletini for the lady, and I will have another Budweiser, and you know what? Give me two shots for this date. I will finish those drinks, right? And then she'll finish hers. And as she's drinking it, she's like, smells fruity. I'm doing such good stuff. There's no gluten in it either. I like this drink. I can't feel my lips. I'm like, that's a good sound. But I'm going to have another drink. Would you like another drink? You can have another drink if you want. No pressure. I am not that creepy guy. But I'm definitely going to have another drink, because not only am I a giant, I'm a raging alcoholic. And that's how I just bury my problems like that woman over there. That's the first time she didn't laugh. She was like... Oh, no, actually, she was distracted. She's ordering another drink. I was just, she doesn't care. So I will say, do you want another drink? And she'll be like, well, that apple teeny was good. Yeah, let's do another drink. Let's do shots. Woo! That's when the woo sound comes out. That woo sound is you just going, fuck my problems, fuck my stuff. I've drowned it. I'm going to party tonight. And that woo sound, ladies, if you're not aware of this public service announcement to you, that woo sound you make is a mating call for all the men in the bar. We hear it, and it's like... Sounds like somebody's about to make some bad decisions tonight. Please choose this. Wow, you guys are having fun early in the show. A lot of people are getting laid tonight or just throwing up on the... holding their shoes while their friend holds their hair. I don't know how tonight's gonna go. Oh, so much fun. Love it. Single. See, beautiful couple. You guys look happy. You look like you're gonna make it. It's gonna blast. My last girlfriend, she broke up with me via text. Anybody else ever been broken up with via text? Has anybody gotten broken up with via text right now? You don't know because your phone's in a wetsuit. Some of you might be single by 10 o'clock. This is what happened. It's basically, I started dating age inappropriate. I'm just going to admit it. Here's the thing: is I'm 46 years old. I've been trying to date like women who are like my own age appropriate. You know, we have more in common, more to talk about, like real stuff. My problem is, I will meet a woman who's like, you know, like late 30s, mid 40s, mid 50s if I'm loaded, right? And we found the AARP group. My problem is I will meet somebody new, right? And we will really bond. We'll really like connect. And I'm like, we're sitting over drinking. I'm like, this is amazing. Like, we are really connecting here. Why don't we do something crazy? Why don't we do something spontaneous? Remember being spontaneous? Like, let's do this. We live in LA. Why don't we just drive to LAX and fly to Vegas for the weekend? It's only a half hour flight. We'll just fly to Vegas for the weekend. Let's do it. Let's go crazy. Problem is, women my own age are like this. Well, I don't think so. I made a lot of mistakes in my 20s. And I learned from them. So now I'm only dating women in their 20s. So I can be that mistake. And they learn a whole lot from Professor Bronston real quick. My favorite part about that is anytime I tell that joke, there's usually some girls like right out of college, maybe even college age, in their 20s, and they're like this, excuse me, did he say fly to Vegas? He's not even gonna ask for half the gas money? Let's go! Meet me after the show. The thing is... I'll just end this show now. Let's just get out of here, whoever would. I got in this business to try and get laid. It never works, but this is it. This is the night, everybody. The problem with dating women in your 20s, whoever really is about to take me up on that offer, is this, is you guys don't communicate in real life. It's all, everything's via text. Everything's via text messaging. Like, you know, because the thing is, women like to communicate, and they like to communicate, like, a lot, which is why men basically sit around and get drunk, you know? But in the old days, you used to be able to leave and go somewhere else and listen to people talk about nothing and have silence. But now, texting is immediate. It's like whatever thought goes through their minds, like... And the problem is when you have a fight now, is in the old days, you used to have a real-life human fight with somebody, and you'd be like, you know what? I don't want to put down the toilet seat. Slam the door, go off and get loaded with your buddies, right? And she'd go off and get loaded with her friends, and your buddies are like, really? You guys aren't together anymore? You're going to fight? This is the end of it? Can I get her number, dude? And she's hanging out with her friends. And like basically, you know, in the old days, it used to be like this. Oh, he's not good enough for you. You know, he has no job for you. You deserve somebody better. I don't know. I don't know what you women talk about. I don't listen. I told you that already. Jesus Christ. Hold on. Before I come off as a total misogynist, I do love women. I love them all. Hold on. That was just a sincere moment in my mind where I'm like, I think I'm acting like a total asshole up here. Here's what happens now. You get in a fight with somebody. You're like, I don't want to slam. Put the toilet seat down. I'm leaving. You slam the door. Before you get into your car, there's already a text going, you're an asshole. Right? And then when you get to the bar with your buddies, they just like yawn because they're like, their lives are fucked. Might as well fuck up yours too, right? And so the fighting goes back and forth and back and forth. And she's like, yeah, you should tell him he should get a better job. Hey, it's not that funny. And these texts are going back and forth. And then if you ever been in a text argument with your lover, do you kind of treat your lover like she's a YouTube comment section at that point? Like the shit we say in text, you would never say to somebody that you love, but you would say it to a total stranger who posted a video of a cat you didn't like. And this is what happened. So we got in this big text fight. I got loaded. When I woke up in the morning, I was like one of those, uh-oh. I think last night might have been bad. And I grabbed my phone, and I picked it up, and I opened the text. And when you have to start scrolling through, you're like, oh, this is... I probably should not have told her that I tried to kiss her sister at her cousin's wedding. She probably shouldn't have said, now I understand why your dad left when you were 7. It gets brutal in text fights. So I sent her a text to repair it. I said this, I said, hey, listen, I know we were both out of control last night. I said a lot of things I shouldn't have said. You said a lot of things you definitely shouldn't have said. Why don't we get together and see if we can talk this over? I will buy you brunch. Because ladies love brunch. She can't turn that down, right?
Bottomless mimosas!
She said no. She texted back, no, I don't think we really need to talk. I don't really think we have that much in common. And so I replied, well, we have great sex together. We have that in common. Can we keep that part of the relationship? Gotta go for the Hail Mary, right? And this is what she replied. This is how she broke up with me. These are the last words I ever heard from this person. My phone vibrated instantly. And I was like, instant's gonna be good. Let's just have a booty call, you know? Makeup sex is the best sex, right, guys? I call it forgive me sex, or I'm sorry, I have a lot of makeup sex. Doesn't really work. That's why this story exists. She sent that text about me trying to keep the sex part of our relationship. Instantly, phone buzzed, and I picked it up. And this is all she said to me. She said, I love your dick. I just wish it wasn't attached to you. That is the most diplomatic breakup ever. Because it starts with a compliment, like, yeah, big guy! And he's just looking up like, you fucked it up again. Too funny. So he told you I'm getting ready to go back to Scotland. I love traveling. You know, I love America, but my favorite thing is when you leave America is you realize like how great. Do you guys ever travel? Do most of you people travel or no? Yeah. I like asking that question in Denver because it's a cosmopolitan city. A lot of you guys travel, go overseas, see other countries. When I ask that question like Kansas City, they're like, travel where? My cousin went to Paris, said McDonald's sucks. I don't understand why you go there. I said that 2 nights ago, and these people from Kansas City went, shut up, we travel! I was like, yeah, all the way to Denver. Woo! But I love traveling overseas because it was when you're overseas is you can look back at the U.S. and you can realize how great parts of this country are. You start missing things. Like, you're like, you know, there's certain things you just can't get over there. Like, honestly, they do. They have shitty fucking McDonald's over there. And but when you also look back, sometimes you look back at America from the outside and you realize, we are fucking crazy. How did I survive there, right? I will tell you this, is over in the UK, they get all of our TV. This was something I didn't know. They get all of our television shows, they get all of our sitcoms and stuff. You know, they get them a little bit late. Like, they don't know that Ross and Rachel, they're gonna make it. Right? They get all of our, like, crime dramas. They love our crime dramas. My buddy from London, he was talking to me, and he's like, oh, I love Law & Order SVU. I watch it all the time. I love Law & Order SVU. But I have a question. I'm like, what's your question? He goes, is it accurate? Like, I don't know what that means. And he goes, is America really, really that violent? And I'm like, don't be ridiculous. No, that is fiction. America is way more violent. On their best week, 3 people die. That's nothing in our country. It's crazy. They get all of our reality shows too, and that's just nuts. Like, who actually likes reality shows, or you like, it's a guilty pleasure and you watch them because you're like, at least I'm better than those fucking people. Like, reality shows are the celebration of the worst, worst, worst parts of America. They really are. It's like people having a conversation, somebody asks a question, somebody answers something that has nothing to do with, doesn't make any sense, and then they just start insulting each other, right? That's all any reality show is. But last August, I was in London, and I was sitting with my buddy, and I was watching a live show being broadcast from the US, a live reality show, and it had all the samples, all the staples of every reality show, like people just making no sense at all, where you're looking at them, you're like, I really don't understand what that person's saying. Someone else calling him an idiot, loser, back and forth, all this stuff. And then finally, my English buddy looks at me and goes, really? Are Americans really this stupid? To be fair, we were watching the first Republican debate. And now the crowd is divided. But trust me, conservatives, I will make these jokes funny. I need these jokes to be bulletproof. Oh, the groaning. That was purely like liberals just going, oh, he insulted them. But my buddy was like this. He goes, Donald Trump, the apprentice, he might possibly be the next president. And I was like, oh, don't be ridiculous. America's not that stupid. I'm actually terrified of his presidency. I'll just admit it, like, he terrifies me. And so I won't make a lot of jokes. Like, I used to have all these Donald Trump jokes because it used to be hysterical, and now it's just terrifying. But the one thing I do have from it is like, this is what you should do. Just gather all your buddies together, all your best friends, people who are really involved in politics or whatever, and put on like a 40-minute speech of his, and get as much alcohol as you can possibly afford. And put it in front of you and play the Donald Trump drinking game. And this is how it goes. If he's doing a 30-minute speech, this is what you gotta do. Is every time Donald Trump says something that insults a group of 10 to 200 million people. You gotta take a shot. If he insults 1/5 of the world population just based on their religion, you gotta drink a whole bottle. If he insults 50% of the world's population by insulting women, just fucking drink the table. And what I'm saying is within 5 minutes of playing this game, within 5 minutes, you might actually be drunk enough to vote for Trump. Trump. Real fast, just so the Republicans don't think I'm just making fun of you, here's a joke for you guys. Do you guys know that Bill and Hillary Clinton, they just had a new grandbaby two weekends ago? Yeah. Chelsea Clinton gave birth to a beautiful, beautiful baby boy. And the grandparents were so proud, Chelsea was so happy. But what she really wanted to do, she wanted to make sure that Hillary, the grandmother, would show as much maternal love as humanly possible, just ask about the baby every single day. Really find out what's going on in that baby's life. And so she named it Super Pack. And every day she's like, come here, my little. Come on, you're so beautiful. You're so pretty. My little bundler of joy. I'm a Bernie supporter. I'll say it. I'm a Bernie supporter. Yeah. The best part is when I did that, we used to say that, say 3 months ago, everybody's like, woo! And now Bernie supporters are like, woo. Just giving up hope. I will tell you this, I'm a Bernie supporter, and I was a Bernie supporter before I even heard of the guy. I didn't even know who he was. For years, I've been like supporting Bernie, apparently, because for years I've been telling my ex-girlfriends to go feel the burn. And if they do, to get tested. I'll tell you guys, you guys are amazing. This is incredible. And I love that this room is full right now. Do you guys realize what you guys have done that's unbelievable? Is you did something that's so rare in our country anymore, and you should give yourselves a round of applause for this. First things first, you left the fucking house. Right? You shut off your idiot box. I'm sure your TiVo's still real busy keeping up with them Kardashians for you, though. Some people say television is a cancer in American culture. If that's the truth, the Kardashians are fucking Chernobyl. The Jersey Shore, whatever, that was just genital warts. Hurricane Sandy came along and blew that off the air. But my least favorite reality show is finally canceled. My least favorite one. Do you guys know this? I think this is the worst celebration of the worst parts of America. Do you guys know the one about the little American beauty princess? Yeah, Honey Boo Boo from Tiaras. The fact that she could go all the way through the history of Honey Boo Boo really terrifies me. Honey Boo Boo. Honey Boo Boo used to just make me mad because it was like just celebrating the worst parts of America. And like, you know, I'd be flipping channels and I'd come onto a scene and everybody would be like, you go, honey, you can do it, Boo Boo, go, Boo Boo. And she'd be like, I know. Or like you'd be flipping channels and you'd come into like there'd be the commercials promoting the next week's show and they're like, next week on Honey Boo Boo, Mama June eats the rest of the year. All right, that joke did not work. So you're really gonna hate this next one, trust me. Buckle in. Honey Boo Boo. I just hated the fact that the show existed. I hated it so much. And every time I saw any kind of a reminder of it, it made me think this in my head. It was really mean. But I really thought to myself, Honey Boo Boo. Not Honey Boo Boo the actual girl, but Honey Boo Boo the show. I was like, that is a 25 trimester too late abortion. Don't be pro-life in here, guys. Pro-laughs. Come on. Pro-laughs. Shit. Abortion jokes are all in the delivery. Let it gestate. It'll come to term. Even Catholic priests laugh at that joke. This guy's laughing too hard at the abortion material. He's like, I'm so pro-life, I'm pro-choice, I have receipts to prove it. He just went like, no, I don't. Because his girlfriend or wife won. But you guys did. You came out in a real live room, and I love it. I love hearing laughter. I think laughter is the greatest thing in the world. You came to a room to hopefully share a laugh with people. I love, and I love laughter. I think laughter and love is as close as most of us will ever get to heaven. Me especially, and I only did 2 minutes on abortion. So I was going to say this to you, is when you leave this room and you go back to your real lives and you celebrate the birth of America and everything great about what is in your life, if people in your life make you laugh, please, 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 always, always, always show them your love. And, yeah. And real fast, if I made any of the women in this room laugh at all, if somebody could show me some love out in the dumpster in the back, I'd really, really appreciate it. Denver, thank you guys so much. This was such a wonderful weekend, and your show's even getting better.